You destroy Kindred. Dude, I mean, I've gone against like some of the hardest matchups as Kindred. Oops. And it's been going pretty well. Yeah, should I just mark Thresh right now? Should I do Thresh?
I have Potato Blast in my
Oh, the Q missed. Ah, darn. Fregler, welcome back. Thank you very much for the resub, man. Appreciate the continued support a lot. Thank you very much, dude. The War Panda, welcome back. Thank you for the resub as well. 2 months in a row. Fregler, thank you as well. I don't know how many months Fregler was, but thank you, man. 2 months as well. Everyone's 2 months. Okay, so we're not gonna double jungle, it seems. No problem. Play AP Kindred jungle.
Son, where'd you find this?
I use 380 Quince, 9 armor, pen marks, 9 armor stills, 9 armor clips on Kindred. I do really well, especially early game. Yeah, that's pretty similar to mine. Pretty close. I wouldn't say that's a terrible page. Might not be the most optimal, I'm not 100% sure yet, but yeah, it's not a bad page. Again, while you're clearing, you want to be moving. Start your W, and you want to be moving while you're clearing, just to take advantage of your W passive. Now, I am against a Lee Sin, so I feel like it is kind of likely that he might invade. Especially because Kindred is a new champion, he might think that I'm weak. Oops, there we go. And yeah, again, you want to keep moving because, actually, I'm going to mark Lee Sin now. Because I'm actually going to go for the... I'm actually going to go for the crab after this, just for the mark. Yeah, Mark Lee Sin, because I'm probably going to run into him if he stayed bot side. We'll have to see. Alright, I'm going to save my spells just in case I do find him. Okay, let's kind of get some information here real quick. I'm full HP, basically. Okay, so he did do Grom. That's weird. So he started Grom. Blue, Wolves. Might be ganking top actually soon then. I want to be careful top. Alright, we're going to get Rangers, Pink Ward, and we're going to keep our totem. Oh, there's the top lane gank. Called it. Hopefully my Pink saved her. I don't know. No, it doesn't look like it. Okay.
Wait for them to flee.
Got it. 88 attack damage. Dude, I'm so sorry about this cough. I hate coughing at stream. I don't know why I developed a cough. I have no idea. Okay, we're just gonna keep firing for now. I'm using like all my mana here because I about to get blue. Alright, level 4. Cool. Just keep once and I think everything here will die. Sweet. And perfect. We can just go get that now. Real quick. I'll worry about the crab later.
In our shadow.
I wish I kind of saved my smite now. But if I saved my smite, I would have gotten here later. So. I think they should be careful considering that if Lee's not here, he may be bought. It's not a guarantee, but something to keep in mind. Notice the mini wave just crossed, which means it just crossed here, so it won't spot me even if I were to walk around. Oh. Nice. I just wanted to make sure he came into this. Sweet. You keep going. Nice. Now, Wolf. Dude, I love, like, Kindred's concept. It is so cool. Like, Kindred just not the concept. The what is it called, man? The champion. Like, not her kit, not her damage, not her like abilities or anything like that. Just like her voice acting and the personality. Like, it's so cool. So let's get Gromp real quick while we're here. There we go. Maxing my Q first. That's actually what I did wrong when I first started playing Kindred on PvE. I was maxing my E first. Huge mistake. Maxing Q makes it so much better. Yeah, her theme. There you go. Her theme. That's the word I'm looking for. Or her lore, I guess. Like, yeah, just that. You know, it's such a cool design. Okay, sweet. We have enough for warrior already. It's crazy. 6.5 minute warrior, and I also have more on top of that. Let's get longsword for now. Now, just something to kind of put out there. So you saw how I counter ganked the top side. I didn't just walk into them like, "Hey, look at me, guys, I'm here," and then have them run away. No, I waited till Lee Sin committed. I went into here knowing that Lee Sin would probably chase her down, and then showed myself when it was too late for him to escape. And that's something that you guys definitely want to like always keep in mind. You know how to gank better. Because a lot of people will mess that up. They'll show themselves too early and lose out on a free kill.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
His blue buff is actually just about to be up, and we know that because he went topside at level 4, right? It's just, yeah, there it is, right there. I'll mark Thresh for now. No one else to mark, I can't mark Lee. We should fight for this. We should definitely fight for this.
Hurry, Lem. Faster.
Oh, guessed it. Nice. Can you get this? He hasn't. Oh yeah, he did get that at least. Okay, he did something good there. That was an interesting Thresh prediction, though. I actually didn't think you'd predict that I would go that way. Come on, I am Nero, please. Now watch how fast we can do this dragon. It's insane. Max on my W second, by the way. I'm basically, so it's kind of slower than usual. And Tom ate me for no reason again. But you know, you get the idea. Very fast dragons. My passive there. Ooh, and we can mark Lee Sin soon. And if you guys have any specific questions regarding, like, anything about Kindred, let me know so I can answer him. Because, like, I think what happens is I fall into this habit of thinking everything is too basic, like, when I play a champion too much. And I might be forgetting something pretty important. Why do you prefer Warrior over Devourer with Kindred Jungle? Well, Warrior did get buffed, Devourer got nerfed, and I don't know, it kind of helps her early game a lot. The early AD, while maxing her Q is actually really nice as well. But it's mainly for just a better early game. If I had to answer one question, or one answer. That's a lot of damage. We should be okay. Is he taunting me right now when he is 0-2? Is that what's happening? Let's just go into this jungle and mess with him. we can fight this. We have Lulu ult. Oh. Oh. Come on, you can get both of them. Dang, dude, I misplayed that. I misplayed that really, really hard. Max and W second. I could have killed Lee Sin if I had vision. Or if I played that a little bit better. It's okay though, not a huge deal. I had a lot of gold as well. Let's finish boost before my Bork finish, actually. That might be better. Feathers falling on her. Might be better for the chase against Lee. So right now we're doing pretty well against a very high damage early champion. Again, this guy, just to kind of put it out there, again, this guy isn't bronze or anything. He's a high elo jungler, so Kindred is looking good. Like, she's looking good. This guy's not bad. I'm thinking she's, like, might be something I might start recommending to people to climb elo with. I mean, she's getting banned quite often, though. Like, is she getting banned in your guys' elo? Chat, is she getting banned in your elo? I smell pride. What's the combo? You basically Q in, E, and then W. Just like that. Sweet. Very easy kill. And we got a mark for that. Ah, darn, dude. That Ahri got her charm off at 1 HP. That kind of sucked. That was really, really close. My bad. I could have played that better, too. I did smite the crab after the ulti. So I got the ulti heal, and I got the HP heal from my ranger smite on the crab, but still wasn't enough. Unfortunately. Juke the Q. But the stalker smite ulti. POP. Okay, my bad on that one. What, 7 stacks at 13 minutes? That's actually a lot, super early on. So that's also pretty good. I did kill Thresh as well, if that matters at all. Dude, this Thresh is such freelo though. Darn, that's gonna be my last camp stack too. Because,
shall we, dear wolf? Race you there!
Oh, thank you, Tom Catch. I don't get a heal now, though. So hopefully you can kind of get, like, see her mechanics, like how you want to play it out, you know? Your ulti makes you invincible. You can use that, especially if they're running away from you. You know, your Q is good for dodges. You can still auto-attack in between your Qs. Sorry, hold on. Just rolling. And here's the dragon speed. Crazy dragon speed. Let's see if we can get him over here. Oh! Dang, I need one more hit for my E to go off. RIP.
How long will we be together?
Nah, that's fine. Let's get out of here. Dang, I still didn't get the stack on Graves though. I wish I stacked Thresh instead, or targeted Thresh instead. I would have already had my stack by now. And again, one of the most important things as Kindred is like, whether you're farming or killing people, keep moving, keep moving. Like, it's kind of basic AD carry knowledge, like, hey, you want to keep moving while you're attacking, but like, her passive on her W is very, is completely reliant on movement. So make sure you're moving.
A careless step.
The plays. I know Vlad was near here, but I don't want to jump over the wall and run into him. And then you can see the regen, like the regen is pretty good too. Let's get back. So we're gonna go for Bork finish and then Hurricane.
Forged in a land unwelcome to us.
There we go. Actually, we're gonna wait for the totem upgrade as well. I actually like the totem a lot more than Sweeper. Yeah, you can change your target out of combat, I know that, but I kinda figured I could kill Graves eventually. You know what? We're gonna switch that target to this guy, the Toxic Ribbon player. He seems to be an easier target. Might have to do with his toxicity, I don't know. Trying for 5k gold again. White Wars on Kindred is just really good on her early. Mr. Listerine 15, welcome back, dude. Thank you very much for the resub.
Fear makes the chase more fun.
Now.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
Alright, let's keep going. Yeah, I've always, I tried both Warrior and Devourer and I found the most success with Warrior, guys. It also helps a lot with the matchups like that are very aggressive early, like Lee Sin. Their speed's pretty good, as you can tell. See what we can do here. Apple, do you think I can become a pro league player if I practice hard? I do. I do think so, man. Yet. Aw, oh, man. I messed that up, dude. I could have played that so much better. I honestly could have played that like 10 times better, I'm pretty sure. Like, I panicked when Graves got close to me. Graves is really strong. My bad. I'm bad. Alright, let's still work for the Last Whisper or BT. Looking at their items, they have a little bit of armor on Thresh, but that's about it. think we'll be okay with BT, actually, this game. The BT buy. Alright, let's make a new target as well. Thresh has died 9 times, so that's a... Actually, let's just mark Lee Sin. Lee Sin's pretty easy to kill, too. Mark the people that we know we're gonna kill pretty easily. Now, if we wanted to... If we wanted to, we could duo Baron, like, super, super easily. Alright. Have Hurricane now, that'll help a lot in the 1v4s. If we run into another 1v4, that is.
Follow their tracks.
Let's see what we can do here. I guess we're just gonna. Yeah, they're gonna get the dragon real quick. We'll just be patient. Their team is playing like really passive. That's our third dragon, sweet. Okay, let's just keep pushing this side and then if someone comes to us, we'll try to fight them. I have a lot of farm, 140 at 22 minutes, which is one of the highest I've had actually recently. I'm so dumb. Gosh, dude, I am so dumb for doing that. Oh my gosh, dude, that was so stupid. Okay. I thought he was gonna miss his hook. The thing is, I can't ulti when I'm in his hook. You can't do anything when you're hooked, and you can't do anything when you're charmed. And I was like, hooked and then charmed, so I couldn't do anything. But like, the point is, like, I shouldn't have went in it in the first place. That's right, go Elise. Make up for my stupidity. My gosh, dude. Okay, let's not do that again. No more gray screen. That's enough gray screen for today. How's the reset on Kindred's Q work? Also, what's your take on Hurricane? Both Sneaky and Abiquiu probably said it sucked. Well, they're ADC mains, not junglers, but I think Hurricane's really good on Kindred. I like it a lot. For the passive, it's the same thing as Kalista. Well, I guess Kalista works with Ren, right? But her passive gives you a lot of percent HP, 10% on hit. That works really, really well with Hurricane. So I can't really see it being bad. Also works well with Orc, but what was the first question? The reset on Kindred's Q, basically, you can Q as whenever you want, but the Q cooldown, so right now it's 7 seconds. If I press my W, it'd go to a flat 2 seconds. Hold on, let me cement this. We did it. Kind of. I got the slow, right? I don't know why, but you can flash Kindred slow. That doesn't make sense to me. Why can you flash Kindred slow? Just in case. You can flash her E. I don't get that. Oh wait, it was laggy? Oh really? Oh my gosh, dude. My computer's dying or something, I have no idea. Sorry about that. Hopefully the lag's gone now. Sorry. Sorry. But yeah, I don't know why, but you can like flash Kindred's E. I think that's a bug. Like, you press your E, it goes off, goes on cooldown, but it doesn't work. Like, because it's not a skill shot, it should still hit you, right? For some reason, you can flash it. It doesn't make sense. But, oh well. It's a good game. That was some damage dealt. Your Q gets reset to a 2-second cooldown no matter when you used it, no matter what cooldown it is. It's a